Now to the GOP presidential race. Voters are heading to the polls in Wisconsin, Maryland, and the District of Columbia today, and Mitt Romney is hoping the results will help him become the presumptive nominee. Fox News contributor and former vice presidential candidate Sarah Palin is here with her take on the race. She's also the author of America by Heart, Reflections on Family, Faith, and Flag. Governor Palin, it's good to have you with us. Good morning.
Thank you so much. Good morning.
So if Governor Romney does well in Wisconsin today, in Maryland and District of Columbia, it seems he is the nominee. Are you happy with that?
You know, anything is still possible. There can still be a bit of a shakeup, but the numbers are what the numbers are. And yeah, he does seem to be obviously the front runner. And, you know, I've been of the mindset that anybody but Obama will be so much better for our country.
But you didn't answer the question. Are you happy with that? And it doesn't sound like you're happy with Mitt Romney as the party's nominee.
Anybody but Obama. I honestly believe that anybody running on that GOP ticket would be infinitely better than what we have today with these failed socialist policies.
Would you like to see some more choices? A lot of people are saying it is not too late to shake this up at the convention. Someone like Chris Christie or Jeb Bush or Mitch Daniels or Sarah Palin could come in here and shake things up and give Republicans another choice.
There is no perfect candidate. And, you know, I would warn voters to never put their faith wholly in an individual, in a politician, because a politician will disappoint you. But have faith in what that politician stands for, what their record represents, and in the choices that we have in the GOP now, the four gentlemen who are running, they're all good. They all have their strengths. And as I say, America will be better off with any of them.
Let's talk about one of your strengths. When you came on the scene in 2008, you had your detractors. You were a polarizing political figure. But one thing that everybody realized was that you had the ability to stir the passion of your base. Governor Romney doesn't have that ability. Is it a major flaw for a candidate at this stage of the game?
He will have that ability to really
bolster
that
enthusiasm.
Aren't you born with that? You know, because people understand that America is at a crossroad right now and that we have a choice in what direction we'll head. We'll either be able to build on the foundation of liberty and individual freedoms here in America and that entrepreneurial spirit, or we'll go down the other road of these failed socialist policies that Obama has done to this country.
But Governor Romney, in your opinion, can all of a sudden develop that skill? He can get the guy sitting at the bar in Alabama or the woman in the factory in Des Moines to feel he's one of them?
You know, he will be able to do that. If not Romney, if one of the other GOP candidates happen to surpass Romney in the delegate count, and whomever it is, Matt, yes, we'll be able to really coalesce. We will be able to coalesce around that nominee and make sure that voters understand that they have a choice here in which direction America is going to head.
Let's talk about the economy. You think it's improving?
For whom? Maybe for those, some on Wall Street, but not for the millions still unemployed, not for those whose houses are underwater, not for those who are having to settle at this point with a job that is not fulfilling for them financially.
But jobs are coming back. The numbers will come out on Friday. They could be 200,000 new jobs created. Manufacturing is looking better. The stock market is looking better. Consumer confidence is up.
We still have fewer jobs today than when Barack Obama took over. And we have debt being incurred at $3 million a minute. Our government is spending too much money, and people are understanding that we cannot keep going down the path that we're heading.
Even the Speaker of the House, I sat down with him, John Boehner, last week. I said, is the economy improving? He said, yes, it is. And I said, so how do Republicans run against an improving economy? He said, you say it should be better.
It should be a lot better.
But is that a bumper sticker that's going to inspire people?
It could be a lot better. Look at take just one example of an indicator of the economy that is still pretty woeful. Gas was $1.83 a gallon when Barack Obama took over. Now we're looking at $4 and $5 a gallon gas because Barack Obama has no energy policy for this country. He has thwarted opportunity for resource development in this country. Again, people have a choice. Do you want to fire that CEO of our country and replace him with somebody who knows how to allow the private sector to create jobs, how to responsibly develop resources.
If things seem to get better or be getting better, why would I take that chance and change the person in the White House?
Because things aren't getting better fast enough, and they should be. And people who are hurting, people who are seeking that job, people who want to hold on to their businesses and to their homes and to be able to afford to send their child to college, people know that we have opportunity to do even more, be better in America than what we're doing today.
If Mitt Romney is the nominee, one of the first real major decisions he'll have to make is on a vice presidential candidate. When you were plucked from obscurity in 2008, you'd been Alaska's governor about 2 years. You didn't have any real experience on the national stage. And in this era of intense media scrutiny, you took some lumps. You had mixed results, as we all know. Do you think if Mitt Romney's the nominee, he should choose someone with more experience on the national battlefield than you had at the time?
Well, you know, I would put up my record as a CEO of a city, of a state, as an oil and gas regulator up against any of the other potential GOP vice presidential nominees last go around. So, you know, I'm proud to stand on my record as a private sector and a public servant CEO.
But if you were advising Mitt Romney, would you say go out and get someone who is battle tested on a national level?
I would say it doesn't matter if that person has national level experience or not. They're going to get clobbered by the lamestream media who does not like the conservative message. And it doesn't matter if that person has been a known commodity to the mainstream, lamestream media or not. The GOP ticket, to tell you the truth, Matt, doesn't know what's coming. They don't know what's going to hit them in terms of double standards being applied to them in the positions that they hold and the records that they are running on, from personal family issues to anything else. There will be that double standard applied no matter who it is. What I would advise Mitt Romney or whomever the nominee would be is, don't necessarily play it safe and do just what the GOP establishment expects them to do, and that is to get somebody kind of just going along to get along, not willing to go rogue and shake it up and say that we need relentless and we need sudden reform of our government to put it back on the side of the people.
Governor Sarah Palin. Governor, thank you very much. I appreciate it. And I want to mention to people you are going to stick around and join us for our 8 o'clock hour, which technically makes you part of the lamestream media for that hour. I just want you to know. It's nice to have you here.
Thank you so much.